Today, WESH 2 got a behind-the-scenes look at the world's most dominant space launch provider.
While the tour itself was classified, WESH 2 Space Coast reporter Megan Moriarty explains how SpaceX and NASA are collaborating to launch more than 100 times this year.
2, 1, engines full power, and lift off.
SpaceX Falcon 9 rockets are launching and landing on the Cape on average every 2 days. On Friday, we got inside their manufacturing facility, and while the tour was classified, we were able to see the Falcon 9 first stage boosters up close. Some of these have been reused and refurbished 30 times. We also saw the payload fairings, which are the protective shells on the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, which are also reused to improve launch efficiency.
It's so important to see, we see behind the scenes, the future of America.
Congressman Mike Haradopoulos is the chairman of the Subcommittee on Space and Aeronautics. When asked about SpaceX's plans to bring Starship to the space coast, he reiterated its importance in getting us to the moon and later to Mars.
We're optimistic that we'll win this, but we're always going to put safety as of paramount importance, and we're going to make the investment in technology so we can win the space race and ultimately get to Mars.
SpaceX says it's confident that Starship will not disrupt other launch operators at Kennedy Space Center or Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, and that it wants to be a good neighbor. There's been some concerns from community members about the disruptions that Starship could cause.
I've had long sit-downs with both NASA and the private sector about what will the impact be. These are very much the same concerns we had going back to the Mercury and Apollo days, what kind of impact. The beautiful thing about Florida is by launching here, we're not launching over people.
Starship is critical in getting American astronauts back to the moon and eventually to Mars.
We recognize some of those concerns. As you know, Starship 10 was a success, but they still have a long way to go before they get here to Florida.
Covering the Space Coast, Megan Moriarty, WESH 2 News.